Hello everyone, it's a sunny morning. I bought live Daphnias earlier. Unfortunately, most of them are dead already, but there are still few live Daphnias swimming in this tank. And there's a couple of mosquito larvae as well. I decided to filter all Daphnia using my fry net since it has very tiny holes. I then shake the net to remove excess water. After adding fresh water to Daphnias, I then feed all my fish. I start feeding my beautiful angelfish first. I have not yet cleaned this tank, and you can see a lot of algae growing in the sides already. Next are my swordtail fish. This fish has some serious jumping issues, which is why one of the swordtail is in my mully fish tank. And this male swordtail keeps bullying the male mully fish. That's why my male mully fish is afraid and stays under the sponge filter most of the time. I also fed my Dalmatian mullies with live Daphnias. My glow Daphnias loves any kind of food, especially live foods. And lastly, I fed my betta fish too. After feeding, I decided to clean my angelfish tank. I use my DIY scraper to scrape algae in front easily. Algae are very beneficial to the ecosystem, but too much algae makes my fish tank look ugly. The top surface is the hardest to scrape since this is where calcium buildup is formed. So I will need more effort to remove this thing. After 1 million hours, I finished scraping all the algae in front, but I'm keeping the algae in the other sides of the tank and at the bottom to grow algae on the floor. For example, one of my fish tank here is already covered with algae, and its natural looking add more beauty to the fish tank. I can also see that the filter box is growing algae, and the cotton fiber filter also turns dark, which means the filtration system is really doing great. But I still decided to take out the filter box for checkup. Some of the holes are clogged with dirt already, so I use sharp stick to clean the holes for better filtration. After cleaning the holes, I installed the filter box right away and connected to the air pump to start working again. I then prepare a chair where I can place the tub. I also prepare the siphon hose and fill it with tap water. Now it's time to siphon all the dirt, including fish poops, food leftovers, and algae that I scraped earlier out from the fish tank. After siphoning and removing water from the fish tank, this water will be drained right away, and sometimes I retain a small amount of water to use for watering the plant since it contains nutrients necessary for plants. It's time to fill up the tank. I'm using a 10-liter plastic bottle and fill it with water straight from the top. I use tap water when doing water change in all my fish tank to build immunity. It's a large tank, so I need 2 times to fill up the tank again. And I can see how happy they are with the new water I just pour inside the fish tank. Finally, a little wipe on the glass surface to remove water marks and dirts. As you can see, they have gotten bigger and healthier ever since I put them in this tank. By the way, I noticed a comment at the last angelfish video that one of them has gill burn. And I think he is referring to this angelfish. It looks like it has gill burn, but I think it's normal because I don't see any problem and the fish is very healthy. Last time when I tried to feed them, they are very shy, but now we are already friends and they let me hand feed them sometimes. Since this is a very spacious tank, I decided to catch my swordtail from the other tank. I was having a really hard time to catch this swordtail because he thinks he is the Flash, but in the end, he gave up and decided to go inside the tub. I also decided to catch the swordtails from the other tank. After catching all the adult swordtail, I noticed one baby swordtail in the tank. So I got 2 males and 3 female swordtails in this tub. And now it's time to transfer them to the large tank where I place my angelfish as well. After acclimating, I noticed all my angelfish were very friendly because they come close to welcome their new tank mates. After releasing my swordtails, I did not see any bullying from the angelfish. So I'm very sure they will get along together. So that's all for today, and thanks for watching.